So I just made this 6-minute video, and when I get finished, I sound like, which is not my normal voice. You know, within that last video that now you can't hear because the sound was so bad, I expounded on the secrets of the universe and everything that anybody should know about the universe. But unfortunately, I forgot what I said, so you're not ever going to know anymore. I know that I was talking about music, and I was talking about the dance. Ah, there it is, the dance. Last semester, I took a dance class through school, and it was a ballroom dance class, and I went to about half the classes and I stopped because the guy that they paired me up with, he was a math teacher and I'm an English teacher, and I mean, come on, English and math, that's like mixing oil and water, cliche. He always seemed so nervous, and I didn't know if it was because it was me or just because he's a math teacher. You know, he has to get everything perfect. So anyway, I grew bored with it, and I stopped going. When I think of dance, I think more of a cosmic thing. You know, I keep comparing life to a dance. Shakespeare said, life's a stage, and all the men and women are merely players, and I do believe that. And I also believe that life is a game. But life is also a dance. And I've been really nostalgic lately. I have on my Louise shirt tonight. Yeah, it's tie-dye. Yeah, it's hippie. And it once belonged to my friend Louise in California. And yeah, that's why I'm feeling nostalgic, is because I've been so homesick for California in the last couple of weeks. I want to see the ocean so bad. I want to see the redwoods. I want to see the forest. I want to see the beaches. And so I put my Louise shirt on to make me feel a little bit closer. But that goes along with the dance, because I danced for a long time in California. And when I say dance, I don't mean I was doing the swing or the Lindy or the jitterbug or whatever kind of dances there are out there. But just that I spent so much of my life there, 40 frickin' years. I don't have 40 years of my life left unless I live to be, don't ask me to do math. You know, and so this dance, we begin to dance when we are born, and at first we have to be supported by other people, our parents, our friends, brothers and sisters, and then we learn to dance in tandem with other people, but we also need to learn to dance on our own, and I don't think a lot of people ever do that. I've certainly learned to dance solo. I have danced with partners, some for a long time, and, you know, my ex-husband for 25 years, even though he wasn't a very good dancer, and a lot of that time, I did dance alone. I come to a stage in my life where I want to have a partner with whom I can dance, and I want him to know the steps, but I also want him to teach me new steps, and I want to teach him new steps. And I want that to be a mutual thing of support. And I want us to be in rhythm. And sometime maybe it'd be syncopated rhythm, but I long to dance. There's a lot of things that I long for right now. I long for California. I long for that partner. I long for the dance. I don't long for winter, but I do long already for spring, because spring is the prime dance. It is a primal dance. I haven't had a good spring for literally years and years and years. And I keep thinking, next spring will be it. Next spring will be it. That's when I will find a partner with whom I can dance. So far, I've been disappointed every year. The dance turns. The universe turns. We turn. I guess that's all I'm going to muse on tonight. I'm going to take my Louise shirt and I'm going to go to bed.